Hello everyone, you're on the Planet Earth channel, and today we're going to talk about the Southern Ocean. Many will say, what kind of fairy tale is this? We studied well in school, and there were four oceans, and now a fifth, the southern one? How is that possible? Well, it is. Everything in our lives changes, and our job is just to keep up with the discoveries and achievements of civilization. Not so long ago, people believed that the planet wasn't even a planet, but a disc supported by elephants, the elephants on whales, the whales on a turtle, and the turtle somewhere in the sea. If I got anything wrong, it wasn't on purpose, and I ask forgiveness from fans of that theory, but we're not like that. We'll conquer the bastions of science and dive into new and fascinating facts that the wise of this world, and not only them, but all who don't want to stand still, often throw at us. It's hard to understand what is unfamiliar, new, and a little scary, which makes it even more exciting. Who could resist such temptation? Only the lazy and the cowardly. But we will be fearless and definitely grasp everything about the Southern Ocean, and we'll rely strictly on facts, so no one laughs at us, and on the contrary, we silently enjoy the triumph of scientific progress over ignorance. Let's go. In 2002, after long debates, the International Hydrographic Organization considered the matter of the Southern Ocean. As a result, 68 countries, and we're talking serious nations, defined the ocean's boundaries along the 60th parallel south, uninterrupted by land, the Southern Ocean according to the SCAR report. And that's not a raven's cry, but the Scientific Committee on Antarctic Research is defined as the part of the world ocean within the subtropical convergence and makes up more than 20% of the global ocean. And in case you're wondering, convergence is where the northern edge of cold Antarctic waters meets the warmer waters of the Atlantic, Pacific, and Indian Oceans. The legal question is settled. We can exhale and move on to more fun, though perhaps irresponsible, but still fascinating stuff. So it turns out the Southern Ocean is bigger than the Arctic Ocean. Exactly, and not just bigger. It's also deeper. The greatest depth lies in the South Sandwich Trench, 8,264 meters. The average depth is 3,270 meters. The coastline is 17,968 kilometers long, which, dear friends, is not insignificant. The Southern Ocean is a vast water body in the southern parts of the Pacific, Atlantic, and Indian Oceans, forming a wide ring around the Antarctic continent. The Southern Ocean is the youngest of all oceans, not only because people invented it in 2002, but also geologically. It formed when Antarctica and South America split, opening the Drake Passage, about 30 million years ago. This separation gave rise to the Antarctic Circumpolar Current, which caught the attention of scientists and became the defining feature of the ocean. That circumpolar current is a surface oceanic current, stretching up to 30,000 kilometers in length and 2,500 kilometers in width, circling the globe in the southern hemisphere between 40 degrees and 50 degrees south latitude. It's the only current on Earth that flows through all meridians. It includes the longest ocean flow in the world, transporting 130 million cubic meters of water per second. That's 100 times more than all the rivers on Earth. If circumpolar is hard to pronounce, just call it by its other name, the West Wind Drift. The Southern Ocean, with its northern boundary at 60 degrees south latitude, differs from other oceans in that its main boundary, the northern one, doesn't touch any land. Instead, it cuts through parts of the Atlantic, Indian, and Pacific Oceans. Several unique processes occur along the coast of Antarctica, producing types of water masses not found elsewhere in the southern hemisphere's oceans. One of them is Antarctic bottom water. Very cold, very salty, dense water formed beneath sea ice. Otherwise, the Southern Ocean is like any other ocean, with seas, straits, and bays. These seas, man, which you won't find in any other ocean, are unique to the Southern Ocean. Lazarev Sea, Risa Larsen Sea, Cosmonaut Sea, Cooperation Sea, Davis Sea, Mawson Sea, Derville Sea, Somov Sea, Ross Sea, Amundsen Sea, Bellingshausen Sea, Scotia Sea, and Weddell Sea. All seas surrounding Antarctica, except the Scotia Sea, are marginal seas. Among notable straits, Drake Passage, Bransfield Strait, and McMurdo Sound. And there are plenty of bays, though many are hidden under massive ice sheets. The most significant are Barras Bay, Dalman Bay, Whales Bay, Lazarev Bay, and Prydz Bay. For those who don't know, a bay and a gulf are essentially the same, just different in scale. For instance, Avacha Bay in southeast Kamchatka covers 215 square kilometers, but that's another story. The Southern Ocean has islands too: Falkland Islands, Kerguelen, South Georgia, South Shetlands, South Orkneys, South Sandwich Islands. There are even Phantom Islands: Emerald, Nimrod, Doherty, Swain. You ask what Phantom Islands are. Yes, they exist, and maybe we'll talk about them in a future video. As for the weather, it's the harshest in the world. Ocean temperatures range roughly from negative 2 to 10 degrees Celsius. Cyclonic storm systems move eastward around the continent and often intensify due to the temperature contrast between the ice and open ocean. The area from the 40th parallel south to the Antarctic Circle experiences the strongest winds on Earth. In winter, the ocean freezes up to the 65th parallel in the Pacific sector and to about 55 degrees south in the Atlantic sector, causing surface temperatures to drop well below freezing. To sailors, the latitudes from 40 degrees to 70 degrees south have long been known as the Roaring 40s, Furious 50s, and Screaming 60s for their brutal weather, stormy winds, and massive waves formed by uninterrupted air currents that circle the globe without meeting any major landmass. Floating ice, especially from May to October, makes the area even more hazardous, and the remoteness from inhabited regions makes search and rescue operations difficult. Icebergs can be encountered all year round throughout the Southern Ocean. Some of them are hundreds of meters long. Smaller bergs in sea ice, 0.5 to 1 meter thick, also pose serious threats to ships. Some icebergs are 6 to 15 years old, meaning at any given time, there may be more than 200,000 icebergs in these waters, ranging from 500 meters to 180 kilometers long and wide. Despite its harsh climate, the Southern Ocean teems with life. As everywhere else, life begins with phytoplankton. Among its species, diatoms dominate, about 180 kinds. Cyanobacteria are fewer in number. The Southern Ocean, especially near Antarctica, is known for massive swarms of krill, Antarctic shrimp. This krill eats phytoplankton, and everybody eats krill: mollusks, fish, birds, whales, and seals. Along the coast of Antarctica, the Southern Ocean's fringe nest around 100 million birds. Petrels, skuas, and of course penguins dominate. These diving, flightless birds make up 90% of the region's avian population. Several species of whales, blue whales, fin whales, sei whales, and humpbacks thrive here, as commercial whaling is banned. There are seals too: Weddell seals, crabeater seals, leopard seals, and of course, fur seals. What would any ocean be without some kind of kitty? So, dear friends, despite conflicting opinions and many people's memorized facts, which is good, by the way, it's worse when there are no facts at all, we have discovered a new ocean, awe-inspiring in its scale, power, and beauty. Some may still ask, why do we need a fifth ocean? Here's an example. Few people know that the Mediterranean contains 11 seas, which in turn break down into micro-seas. Each has its own nature and traits. The same applies to the Southern Ocean, a living, breathing organism of its own kind. And this young ocean is nearly 10 times bigger than the Mediterranean, which itself is one of the largest seas on Earth. Thanks for watching this video. Subscribe, hit the like button, and share it with your friends. It really helps the channel grow. This has been Planet Earth.